everybody, what's up? Kevin here once again from the My Song Today Rock 2000 to Today YouTube channel. And today we are going to be reviewing an album that was 13 years in the making. This is our review of Fear Inoculum by Tool. So for those of you who do not know how our album reviews work or just plumb forgot about it, let me go through it real quick. First, I'm going to give a little background context on the album to kind of catch you up to speed. Then I'm going to go through the songs in order from beginning to end, giving you my thoughts on the meaning of the song, how the instrumentation works, the tempo, the flow, the melody, the harmony, the vocals, everything, and what I think about it, just to give you guys a full-on look song by song. And then at the end, I will give the album a rating on a scale of 0 to 10, 0 being the boogers in your nose, 10 being pure gold. And don't worry, I will always tell you why. So let's get on into it, shall we? No more waiting. Tool, Fear Inoculum. So for your pre-context in the Tool's Fear Inoculum, this is what we're going to go with. This is Tool's fifth full release, the first in 13 years since 2006's release of 10,000 Days. Now, Maynard James Keenan did go on the Joe Rogan Experience back in July, at the end of July, and explained why this album took so long to make. And in his words, he said that the guys are always button heads and they have so many different ideas that they want to make sure that they get it right and make sure that everyone is happy and that it's a great record. So they want to make sure they took their time on this one, which does make sense, but still, 13 years is a long time to wait. One other thing that happened in up to this was that they released all their music on digital platforms for digital downloads and streaming as of August 2nd. So for the past month, people have been able to listen to all their stuff. Now, another little bit of pre-context for me, I'm not really a big Tool fan. I never really got into the band at this point. So I think I'm actually a perfect person to really review this album because you're not going to get some Tool real fanboyness coming in from me. You're going to get just a straight no chaser kind of review. So let's get going. Song number one. So the first song on the album is the only single, which is the titular track, Fear Inoculum. Now, this song dives into being an individual and keeping that individual thought when everyone else wants to have you in that groupthink mentality and really take away your individuality, which is hard to overcome, especially in today's society. This is the longest opening track that Tool has ever had, with it being over 10 minutes, which is, you know, rather long for a track, but it's Tool. What are you going to do? The opening does start out slow, and it does build throughout the song over time, but it has this simple but yet complex construction in the instrumentation, which actually brings you into like more of a marching unison feel, which kind of contradicts the feel of the song and the overall overall meaning of the song, because the meaning of the song is really going against groupthink, but you know, marching in unison feels kind of weird. There is this really consistent African style drum beat in there, which I really do like on this track. It kind of has this interesting vibe to it that kind of brings in, it also brings in this like weird Stairway to Heaven vibe, and I actually thought that was kind of pretty cool. Vocally, Maynard kind of goes with a softer style of vocals here, but he really goes deep into the chorus, and it actually works as the style because it complements the vibe overall really well with softer vocals in the verse and the chorus. It kind of gets a little bit deeper. Overall, I actually did like this one as the first single, but I wasn't too big on it. Like, I wasn't in love with it. But it does have that classic vibe, and it's rather simple to listen to. It's very easy to listen to, and, you know, it just was the runtime. 10 minutes, that can get kind of long, but this one, it was all right. So the second song on Fear Inoculum is the song called Numa. Now, I believe the meaning of the song is to tell us that though, you know, we are completely different, we all have different individual tendencies, that when you boil it down to it in the same, we are basically all the same person, and we can really use our individuality to complement one another. You know, we are born of one breath, one wind, that's part of the song, and I think that really exemplifies that here. This one, again, starts out rather slow, like Fear Inoculum, and builds up to it, but it stays rather slow into when Maynard starts singing, and keeping a very simple instrumentation to it as well. The one thing I really do enjoy about the song is the drumming diversity overall. And then the 6 minute, the guitar rather picks up, and it does go harder in the last 2 minutes, really perk your ears up and get you going throughout the song. However, at this point in the song, because again, it was another 10 plus minute song, I was getting worried at this point that this was going to be a slugfest to get through, because this album is an hour and a half long, and I was really getting worried at this point because I'm like, I'm only two songs in. Is this going to be one that's going to have me, you know, saying at the end, how did I get through this? I don't want to listen to it again. I was worried at this point. All right, coming in at number three. Let me read this one because I'm going to butcher it probably because it's in French. I think it's called Litanie contre le Pire. So if I got that wrong, you know, whatever, I don't speak French. So I looked it up, what the translation was, and it's Litany Against Fear. This is a shorter song, about 2 minutes long, and it is just instrumental. And most of the song just kind of sounded like it was like some distorted noise, which makes me really question why this one was on the record, because it doesn't really serve any kind of a purpose here, and it doesn't really, you know, change up the vibe or anything. It just does not feel like this should be on this album. It makes no sense to have it on. I am a big dislike on this particular track and its inclusion on Fear Inoculum. All right, the fourth track on Fear Inoculum is called Invincible. Now, I believe this song really dives into the 13-year wait that the fans had to take and that the band had to, you know, take in order to complete Fear Inoculum and how much it really took out of them. Again, this is very consistent with the first two songs on this album where it really starts out slow and tries to build up to it. One thing about Maynard's vocals, this one, it kind of gave me a little bit of a Led Zeppelin vibe in there, which I was rather intrigued by, which I'm actually starting to get a little bit more throughout his vocals in this, you know, a little bit of a Robert Plant vibe on there, which of course, you know, can never go wrong with that. And I did like the distortion of the guitar in this one in the beginning, but it does, and it kind of gives it a little bit of a deeper flow in connection with the bass guitar, which I thought, okay, that's interesting. But it was still slow going through it. Around minutes 6 and 7, because again, this is a longer song, the guitar picks up, the beat picks up, the tempo picks up, and it goes into more of a hard rock sound, which I really do like. But listening to it to try and get up to that point, it just kind of, again, a little bit of a slug through. But once I got to that point, I thought, you know what? This is some good stuff. So I like the second half of Invincible. I wasn't really big on the first half. Okay, coming at number 5, we have the song Legion Inoculate, and this is another straight instrumental track. It's a little bit shorter, and it has a little bit of that space rock feel, so it's a little bit more futuristic sound. Best way to describe it is like that space rock sound you would have heard on the original 30 Seconds to Mars album. Did I just make a 30 Seconds to Mars comparison in my Tool album review? You better believe I did. Now, I really don't like this inclusion there, because it completely breaks up any kind of momentum that these longer songs are really building on, and it just makes no sense for me to have it in there. I really do not like this inclusion at all. Again, it just does not serve any good purpose for this album. So halfway through the album, let's go to song number 6, which is called Descending. I believe this one, again, discusses that groupthink mentality and how humanity is kind of descending into madness over the lack of identity and individuality that most humans have. And I believe this is a big commentary on the political nature of the world today, especially in the United States, which has been a rather consistent theme throughout this album, is that individual lack of thinking and more of a groupthink style, except for Invincible, where it was more on the long wait between this album and the previous one. Now, it starts out again incredibly slow with some ocean sounds, and then the guitar intro really mimics this, and I'm rather getting tired of this, just because this is the fourth song when it comes to one of those longer songs that they're slowly building up to, and it's just getting repetitive at this point. I'm just like, oh, this is not going well. Maynard's vocals in this one, they really start out soft, and they kind of just flow through soft in the first half, and I was really kind of concerned about this because it really didn't show any kind of range that Maynard could easily show on a track like this. But then the song does pick up in the second half of it, and that's where Maynard's vocals really become a strength. That's because he gets a little more intense, bit more emotional, a little bit more powerful, and I really did like it on this one. The drum beat, I cannot lie on this one. It had that African style drum beat again, and I really do got to give it a thumbs up. And I do enjoy the long outro on this one because it gives it more of like this mellow hard rock vibe, which I really thought was good. So once you hit that second half of the song, it's good. The first half, not a fan. Alright, coming in at song number 7, we have Culling Voices. Now, I believe this song is, again, another commentary about that groupthink mentality, but this one dives a little bit more deeper into the media, really putting people in box and trying to do that divide between one spectrum and the other. Again, another consistent theme with this album, sticking with it, and I'm not gonna lie, I actually am enjoying it because of how metaphorical these lyrics really are. So, again, I gotta give a big ups and upvote to Tool on this one for rather great lyrics when it comes to the metaphors. Now, I've had enough with these slow builds already because it takes so long to get into them, and that's every single long song on this track and this album. And this one is the exact same way, and I'm just getting tired of it. Once the guitar comes in, and it is very mellow, it's very just, it's the same. I'm getting sick and tired of this repetitiveness in the longer songs and how they build up consistently. It's just, it's something I'm really not feeling, and it's really not liking it because it's really taking me out of the album if I'm listening to it song by song and really focusing in on song by song as we go through it, because they're constructed all the same, especially with the intro. Now, when it comes to the vocal pairing here, it really brings this downtrodden feel to the song, which I believe really resonates well with the theme, because yeah, of course it does. Downtrodden, when you're trying to split people up and make them force, you know, against each other, you don't want to do that. The instrumentation in this back one is very simple. That guitar really creates a depressing feel that the vocals really bring in, and you know, I kind of get where they're coming with this one, but it doesn't really fit well. Now, the song does pick up again around that like 6 minutes and 30 seconds part, and the band it makes me think of every time I listen to this one at that halfway point is Chevelle, because it goes hard in that kind of Chevelle style. And this is another one where I'm looking, I'm like, I cannot stand the slow build in the intro. I do like Maynard's vocals on this one, how the vocal pattern connects with the style of the song, but then once you hit that half mark and you go into the harder Chevelle kind of sound, ooh, is that good. Alright guys, come at number 8, we have the song Chocolate Chip Trip. It's another one of those shorter songs in comparison to the longer ones, you know, the sub 10 minute ones, and it has this really weird trippy vibe to it, kind of like Legion Inoculum, but with these chimes, and I can't stand this one again, because especially when it comes to culling voices at the end of it and the second half of it, when it built on that harder kind of style that reminded me of Chevelle, I was really getting into it, and this one completely kind of took me away from it. I was like, wait, are you kidding me? What is this? I don't know, and I'm just getting sick and tired of it. This has got to stop. It's really killing the momentum when you're listening to it completely song by song, and you're really going through it song by song and not listening to it as a whole and just kind of running straight through it. However, I will give up to the drummer on this one, because it does really get going in the song. The beat, I really do like how it drives, and you guys know me, I'm a sucker for the drums, so I got to give him a thumbs up on that aspect, but just for the whole entire rest of it, thumbs down. So song number 9, this is the last long song on the album. It's called, I think, Seven Empaths, but I'm going to say Tempest because I'm pretty sure that's what they were going for. Now the song's meaning, I really believe it comes in that culmination of what happens when these group things are going to go away and people are going to really start focusing on their individual thought and really thinking for themselves and what's going to happen to the political spectrum and, you know, the societal spectrum, anything, pop culture, whatever you want to call it. Again, this one starts out slow with that guitar intro, and when I was going through this one specifically song by song, this is where I thought about just completely rage quitting, because I'm like, I'm sick and tired of the same kind of construction. However, at the 1 minute and 30 mark, the guitar picks up with this shredding sound. I thought, oh shoot, okay, this is where it's going. This is good. And then Maynard comes in with some more intense vocals on this track, and it has that more of a hard rock style that again reminds me of Chevelle, and I love Chevelle, so this is exactly where I want to be. I'm like, this is what I wanted. This is what I was hoping for from Tool. This is some good stuff. It really changed up the rest of the album, because it really sticks with that hard rock sound from that 1 minute 30 mark on through minute, you know, 15, and I was so into it. This was the one where I'm like, I'm so glad they put this one in here, because I don't want to rage quit to the end, because this is awesome. It really fits in with that message, because it goes harder and it really shows kind of that drive to think on your own and to have your individual thought. The guitar solo in that 5th minute around there, it completely shreds. I really do enjoy it, and it makes me happy, because this is what I wanted this album all along. Even as a song, you know, interludes instrumentally through the middle, it does keep that harder sound, so they keep it throughout the whole entire thing. This clearly is the best song on Fear Inoculum, hands down. Hands down. And the last song on Fear Inoculum is song number 10, which is Mocking Beat. Now, this is ending with that kind of like jungle style instrumentation, which, you know, it's rather interesting. I don't mind the tropical drum beat. You know me, I'm a sucker for the drums. However, again, this conclusion makes no sense, because I don't think as an instrumental one, I don't mind if you're gonna do an instrumental outro, but this kind of feels like it's leaving a lot of the album to question. Like, what's gonna happen after this, you know? Kind of leaving it completely open, which, again, I think Tool may have wanted to do that, but I don't know. I just don't feel like this album really kind of came to a good close, especially after the, you know, the intensity and that drive that Tempest brought. Alrighty, now time for the moment of truth. What is my rating on a scale of 0 to 10 for Fear Inoculum by Tool? It is... I'm gonna give Fear Inoculum a 7 out of 10. Alrighty, so I gave Fear Inoculum a 7 out of 10. So let me go through why I like this album, why I gave it, you know, the 7. So I thought when I listened to this the first time through, when I really wasn't going song by song, this album was very easy to get lost into. Even for an hour and a half, I really didn't feel like quitting on it because I did really get lost in it. It really kind of just let me go through it, especially after the second song when I thought about, you know, am I going to really be able to slug through this? It was very easy to get through, especially even again for that hour and a half, very easy to get lost into, which I really did enjoy. And Maynard's vocal range on the song Descending was another key point and why I liked it, because I really thought it was going to be something I wasn't gonna like when I kind of just stuck with that softer vibe. But then once it got halfway through the song and he went with those harder vocals, I thought, you know what, this is exactly what I was hoping for, and I like the mix on this one. It ended up working out rather well. And the second half of Colleen Voices, when it had me thinking, you know, this sounds like that hard Chevelle sound that I really do enjoy, and it's Tool's doing it. This is some good stuff. You know, it's probably Tool's harder sound too. And I'm going to stick with it because I really do like what's going on here. And Tempest being the best song on there, because this is the song that I really wanted to hear, and this is what I wanted this album to be. And it was the longest song on the record. I thought, this is great. So what do I dislike about this album? Why isn't it higher than that? Well, those instrumental songs, those four instrumental songs, I just can't stand it because they break up the album. They make no sense to be in there. They just don't sound really that, you know, important. They don't bring anything to the table for Fear Inoculum. I was not a fan of these, and I wanted these to get out as soon as possible. Now, the other thing I really didn't like about this album was when you got to those longer songs, it was the construction and just that monotony of the slow build, especially for the ones that weren't Tempest, because they all slow built into like the 5th and 6th minute, and it was just repetitive. Just couldn't really stand it. Even Tempest, it took a minute and a half to get into it, which I'm thankful only took a minute and a half, but that slow intro just really, you know, and you're listening song by song, it really just kills you when you're just kind of really analyzing it as you go through the whole entire album. And they really didn't play with that harder sound as much that I would have liked them to. Again, like the second half of Colleen Voices and all mostly of Tempest. So I thought, you know what, that's something I really wasn't that big of a fan of, that they kind of really could have gone further on that. But you know what, it's the band's decision to make that move, and it's up to them. So I just wasn't a big fan of the lack of it, especially when you have 6 songs and really only puts in there for a song and a half, when that softer sound is really for that 4.5 songs. All right, so overall, I think this is a very serviceable Tool album, where the big fans of Tool are going to be like, you know what, this was fantastic. I really did enjoy this, and I am very happy with it. So I think those are going to be where the bigger Tool fans come in, because it is, again, easy to get lost into when you're more of a casual fan like myself. And, you know, the 4 instrumental songs, again, take them out of there completely. If you listen to just the 6 long songs in there, I think this would be a little bit better. And maybe, you know, maybe add like a 7th long one to kind of just complete it out. I thought that would have been a better move. But again, we got 10 songs, 6 full, you know, 10 plus minute, and 4 instrumental, you know, sub 5-minute songs. So overall, did I actually enjoy this album? Yeah, I did. I think the casual fan would like it as well, up to a point. But overall, you know, I think this is the best way to put it. This is a very serviceable Tool album, and was the 13-year wait for this one warranted? In some ways, yes, and in some ways, no. All right, that's it for me. Thank you for watching the My Song of the Day Rock 2000 to Today album review on Fear Inoculum by Tool, that was 13 years in the making. If you like this video, give me that like, but if you dislike this video, give me that dislike, but put in the comments why you like or dislike it, because I want to have that discussion with you. I'll read the comments and I'll respond to them. Also, if you're not subscribed to that YouTube channel, or this YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button. No, not the big one. Get the big one out of here. Hit the little one in the corner, because that's going to subscribe you to this channel. And hit the bell icon too, because you'll get notified when I release videos every single Wednesday, and some special Monday ones like the one you're watching right now. Also, make sure you follow us on social media. So let's get all those rest of that stuff out of there. So follow us on social media, because we're on Facebook. Facebook is going to let you know everything that's going on. So the new songs of the day, the YouTube videos, any podcasts that come out, it's going to be your place. And now, you know, we're going to venture into TikTok, actually. So we'll see what goes on there. So we're going to add that there as well. Also, follow us on Twitter, because on Twitter, we're going to talk to you guys and really get to know exactly what you're thinking about the music. And follow us on Instagram, because that's where we also talk to you guys and get to know what you think about the music. But we do other things as well, such as our IGTV videos, which is more like a blog behind the scenes of what we're going to be doing here at My Song of the Day Rock 2000 today, and our Instagram live streams, where we go live every single Wednesday, Scratch that. We go live every single Wednesday at 9 p.m. Central Time for an hour where you can come ask us questions, ask me questions actually, and then I will answer them and we can just get into one hell of a conversation. I might ask you some questions too. Actually, I do that a lot. It's great fun, so go join us all. Link in the description below to follow all of that. Now let's get that out of here and talk about the Chord Progression Podcast. It's our very own podcast where we do a much deeper dive into this stuff for a longer period of time. And on there, we do some incredible things like interview our followers even that really want to talk about these albums, and I get in a deep conversation with them. I even gotten one on this one that will be released the day after the video comes out. We also talk to some smaller bands that are trying to get on the up and up, so you can stick with some of those bands and get in the know before they hit it big, like GFM or Ascending from Ashes or Kingdom Collapse or Apollo 03 or Trivial Difference or Total Eclipse. I'm just naming the ones that I've done so far off the top of my head. They're all great bands. You should check them out and check out the Chord Progression Podcast because you can listen to us interview them and really get in the know with them before anything else happens. And last but most importantly, if you're not enabling our Alexa skill on your Amazon Alexa device or Amazon Echo device, what are you doing? So hit the link in the description below, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna enable the skill on your device, and you can say, hey Alexa, play my song of the day. Alexa will say, playing your song of the day. You'll get a little intro from me, and the song will play in its entirety. You can listen to it as much as you want in 24 hours, and once those 24 hours are up, you will get a brand new song, so you get a new song every day. It's a great way to discover new bands, rediscover old bands, discover new songs, get your day going, get through a workout, get that nighttime song, whatever you need it for, we're here for you. And we're going to bring you a lot of great stuff, including Small Band Saturday, where those small bands I was talking about, you can actually hear their music along with a little bit of a preview on Instagram as well if you're following us there. It is a great way to get you, you know, through the day. So enable that on your device, and I want to thank you guys again for watching this video and being a part of this because I love doing this. I want to thank you so much for being in the My Song of the Day Rock 2000 Today family, and that's it for me. This is Kevin from the My Song of the Day Rock 2000 Today YouTube channel. You know how we end. Had flip. Still can't get that, but see ya!